When you combine a really matte paint with something shiny or glittery, you get what I think of as paint alchemy, where those really different characteristics contrast strongly with each other to create really interesting effects and blends. In today's video, I'm creating paint magic with DecoArt's Fresco Finish Paint and DecoArt's Extreme Sheen and Galaxy Glitter. This isn't my first video that combines a really shiny or sparkly paint with one that's super matte, but it's the first one with this specific group of paints. So Extreme Sheen is going to produce an ultra shiny metallic look when it's brushed on, and it will really enhance the effect when you brush in the same direction to align the particles. Galaxy Glitter is an entirely different product that features large glitter shapes that are suspended in a clear base. And Fresco Finish Paint is completely matte. Alone, they're great for all of my usual kinds of works on journal pages and mixed media projects, but when you combine them, you create something really special that can be used for just about anything, even cards, if you happen to be a card maker. So the first thing I want to do is, you can see what happens when you start to mix these paints. Here, it's a simple ombre, and you can see that I've got the copper shiny at the bottom. This is on one of our black index cards, and I've got this deeper purple on the top. Really, when I'm working on a gel press plate, which is how most of these were made, it's just a matter of which way you lay the page is going to determine the direction of your shiny versus matte marks, if you want to look at it that way. Sometimes I mix them up and the marks really are not directional. They kind of go all in a mishmash. Sometimes you get patterns like this, but always what you see is the super shiny versus that very, very matte. Now this is actually two different prints that combines multiple colors. You can see the shiny turquoise. Under here, I can just about see it. There was actually some shiny copper, and I used a Fresco paint and in a coral color that kind of pushed that to the back a little bit, but there's just so many different ways that you can combine these to get such interesting effects. So I'm going to bring in a gel press plate. Let's slide those out of the way. And I want to show you what it is I'm going to make. So here is my 8x10 plate. It's kind of centered here. And this is the page that I want to show you. So this is one of our 6x6 white, smooth and sturdy pages. When you see the reflection of the light on the metallic paint, which is the Extreme Sheen, you can see that that was this kind of peridot green, and then when you look into the background, both colors are pretty similar, but especially along in here, you can see the Extreme Sheen. So what I've done is the first base coat, or the first coat on that page, is done with Blue Oyster in the Fresco Finish and Aquamarine in the Extreme Sheen. So I'm going to go ahead and give them both a shake, and then I'm going to grab someplace here. I've got a stack of pages. All right, now I can get them. So again, 6x6 white, smooth and sturdy, nice and smooth, very sturdy, so you can, it will take all this kind of abuse. So I'm just going to go ahead and put some of the color on. Now again, there's no particular rhyme or reason to what I'm going to do here, so it's just a question of either rolling it out. Now in this case, I'm not going to work toward an ombre because I haven't really arranged the paint to make an ombre, but I can show you how to do that if we get to it. So I'm just going to kind of mix these up a little bit. What I don't want to do is mix them to the point where you really can't see any distinction between the matte and the shiny. Now there is a lot of paint left here. So one of the other things that you can do, for example, this is one of our 4x6 black index cards. If I just put this here to the side, you can see that I can go ahead and roll a layer on there, and it's a little hard to see now because obviously everything is wet, so everything is shiny, but that's just an opportunity to use up some of the paint and then to go ahead and, create some other beginnings that you can work off of. So if I lay the 6x6 page here, let's go ahead and grab a black page. Well, we'll put one this way, and then let's just grab a white page and we'll put one that way too. So now I'm just going to grab a piece of scratch paper and go ahead and take these prints. I generally try to choose colors that are high contrast. That's going to really give you pleasing results. You'll see the contrast in both the color and in the finish that you get from each. So you can see this is completely different. It doesn't look like any of the other ones that I did. And here I've got kind of a horizontal pattern going on. And then let's see what our page looks like here. So here is our background. And again, you can see the shine of the Extreme Sheen. So I'm going to take a second and, what am I going to do here? I'm going to take a second and let's just go ahead and print another page because there's a fair amount of paint on here. That'll just take a second. All right, So I'm going to, let's see what this looks like. All right, so again, the whole page is not covered, but then the whole page doesn't have to be covered. It really doesn't make a darn bit of difference. So I'm going to brayer off this excess paint just because I don't want to take the time to go ahead and put it on something else to begin with. And I am going to take a second. Ordinarily, I would not clean this up, but for the purposes of what I'm trying to show you, it's important that I work kind of from a clean plate. So we'll just go ahead and wipe the bulk of this up. All right, that's pretty good. All right, so this is close enough to dry. I think we can make that work. Coming back to our sample. So again, now I've got my turquoise background on there. The next two colors I'm going to bring in are Byzantium, and this is in fact named Peridot. So I'm going to go ahead and give them a shake. Some of the Peridot on, and again, I'm just going for random application here. I'm not necessarily looking for any kind of a gradation. With my mostly clean brayer, let's just roll this on and see what happens. This time I'm really not mixing it all in terms of doing this like I did the last time. So let's see how this looks. Again, while I have a second, let's just come in and brayer that off. And you can see that I now have another beginning, and beginnings are good things. Let's just brayer the rest of that off. So now I'm going to bring in, so this is one of Elizabeth St. Hilaire's first release of stencils for us. It's named Chunky Spirals. I'm going to lay it, it's already got paint on one side, so I'm going to lay it painty side down. And let's get some cleaner scratch paper here. I have a whole stack of it, I just cannot get my hand on it. All right. So I'm going to pick up a lot of the color through the openings of the stencil. Now, if I had thought about it, I could have actually printed this on a page, and I would have had this come out on a page, but I didn't think of it, so we won't do it this time. And because I do want to clean this up a fair amount, I want to see the turquoise background through the stencil openings. I'm going to print this through a second time to clean as much of the paint off the plate as possible. And then we will lift this up and go ahead and pull the print. So coming back to my mostly dry page, if I put this over here, and then I go ahead and grab another black page, let's put it this way, and then maybe we'll grab this page and print that. And another piece of scratch paper just to keep my hands reasonably clean. And let's see what this looks like. See, how awesome is that? You get shine on top of shine, you get interesting layers. Here, just against the black background works really, really well. And here's my page. So again, all the nice contrast between the colors, and certainly the contrast between the shiny and the matte, makes a huge difference. So the other thing that you can do, and again, I'm going to take 1 second and just go ahead and clean my plate off, is if I bring in, if I could find it. So this is the other product from DecoArt that's called Galaxy Glitter. It is big glitter particles, various colors, suspended in a clear base. And while it doesn't look and feel like regular paint, you can combine it with the fresco finish too. So let's just clean this off, and then I have some samples stuck to one side here that I can show you. So let's move these over here and come back. And where did I hide my samples? Here they are. All right, so this is a big index card. It's black, and you can see if I hold this up to the light, you can just see the glitter start to reflect in there. This was a very little bit that was left on something, and I must have pulled it kind of as a ghost print. So there's that. Now here's a background done on one of our watercolor tags, and you would think that because this paint is opaque, that it would actually obliterate and you wouldn't see all those big particles of glitter, but you do. And again, you start to combine all these various layers, and you get some really interesting results. Here's some yellow on black. Again, you see lots and lots of shine. Now this particular page, I had a lot of paint on the plate, which is why I got this kind of random squishiness going on. But through all of that, you still get the look of the galaxy glitter. Again, that's the same one here. So the two colors that I'm going to work with this time, and I'm actually going to reproduce this. The two colors I have, the galaxy glitter is named Ultraviolet, and the fresco finish is sugar plum. Same process, I'm going to put colors down and I'm just going to go ahead and blend them to kind of meld them a little bit, and then we'll see what happens. Now remember that this paint is actually glitter suspended in a clear medium. All right, my semi-clean brayer. Just go ahead and brayer this out. Now, again, I could continue to brayer over this and mix it a little bit more, but I'm choosing not to because these areas that are you can see through, those are areas that are actually going to, you will see the underlying color because that transparent base on the Galaxy Glitter has not, obviously doesn't provide an opacity there. So let's grab, this is a smooth and sturdy, this is a 6x9, this is a bigger one. Go ahead and put that down. Now, one of the things that I like to do is partial print leftover pieces. Nothing says you have to print a whole page. There are no art police that say you must print a whole page. So I get this kind of cool stripe that goes on there. Same thing with, well, let's grab this. So if I come here, I can just print the other side of this and get some color on there. So there's, you know, there's lots of ways that you can use all of this stuff. Let's print this background. And I, again, one of the things that I find the most interesting is how much of the Galaxy Glitter shows. Now, coming back to what I said a moment ago, those areas where you could see through, that's the area here and along in here where there's not a lot of the paint mixed in, so you really do see the glitter much more. But even where there is plenty of paint, there still is plenty of glitter showing through. Now, I've got enough left on here that I could probably brayer out a little bit more, so for the heck of it, let's go ahead and do that and see what happens. And let's do this, and I have some black tags, so let's put that on there, and then let's take a black tag and just go like this. Now, I'm moving relatively quickly because at this point, the layers of paint are pretty thin, and they will start to dry. All right, so again, you still get the color, you still get the sparkle of the glitter. I just think that this is so much fun and such an interesting way to take paints and create interesting kinds of contrast, whether you're talking light and dark, or the contrast between colors, or you're talking the contrast between matte and shiny. Up next, I'm going to bring in some of Kat Kerr's new foam stamps along with a gel press plate, and I'm going to show you that you can use one of the stamps, or any of the stamps really, to lift color and pattern off the plate for an entirely different look. Foam stamps are another effective means for manipulating the paint, and by that I mean adding some kind of pattern and or texture to it. Stencils are a very obvious way to do that, but for example, this is Kat Kerr's new squares foam stamps, and you can foam stamp, and you can see that I used it here to add pattern. Now, I have a tendency sometimes to put out too much paint, and so what I did when I created this trio was to put paint on the plate, go ahead and pick backgrounds up with these two pieces because I realized I probably had too much on there. And then I took what was left on the brayer and what was left on the plate, rolled it out rather, and then manipulated it with the foam stamp. So I'm going to come back again with these colors. I have Niagara Falls and the Fresco paint line, and I have pink tourmaline. All right, let's slide this out of the way. All right, somewhere here I do have some black that I can work on. All right, so now I've got access to that. So, again, giving the paint, all of these paints are supposed to be shaken a little bit, which I probably didn't say, but I should have, so I just did. Go ahead and put this color on. All right, let's still have some leftover paint here on my brayer that I need to get off. All right, go ahead and roll this out. All right, I don't want to manipulate that too much. I don't want to blend these colors too much. The initial rolling will be much less blended, and you'll see that when I come back to do this again, that there is going to be more of the color blending going on because I will have rolled this paint a couple of times. So let's do this, and then let's come across here and just do the other side. And you get that effect. I missed in the middle, but sometimes that's half the fun, right? All right, so here's this. Let's pick this up. Again, plenty of color going on there, lots of patterning, lots of contrast in color, and once the fresco paint dries, there'll be lots of contrast in terms of the shiny versus the matte. So now I'm going to come back, And I'm going to roll these colors out again. So I've got a decent layer on here. You can see that there's definitely more blending going on this time. This is Cat's Crisscross stamp. So I'm going to come in with this. I'm going to put the stamp down. And then I'm going to take a clean piece of paper, and off to the side here where you won't necessarily see all of it, I'm going to stamp the color off. Come back, pick it up again. Stamp it off. And then this time, this is our flower blossom stamp. This happens to be one of my designs, so let's come in and do a flower blossom. Lift that color off, and I think I twisted that. Don't twist the stamp. Note to self. But you get where I'm going here. This is a not fine art I'm making. This is my chance to show you something kind of interesting. All right, so now what I'm going to do, I don't seem to have a clean 6x9, so we'll just print on this and see how this looks. We'll put this here, and then we'll come back with this and go ahead and print it, and then do the same thing here. Again, you get pattern and texture. Now let's grab some paper and give this a good press. Let's see how this looks. Oops. All right. So you can see my flower blossom down here. You can see the crisscross up here. Again, the same kind of thing that we had going on here, we've replicated. The colors are not quite as blended here as they are here, but all of this varies. As they say, your mileage will vary. Exactly what you get is going to depend on what you do. So I'm going to take this plate, step to one side and get rid of it. And the last thing I want to do, well, first of all, what I'm going to do is just mist these stamps and put them face down so that the paint doesn't dry on the surface. Because they, if you've got an accumulation of paint on there, they're not going to work nearly as well. Let's grab some paper towel and just wipe this up. So the last thing I want to show you is how you can take paint and an ink blending tool, and you can kind of do some fun things with this. Someplace here I had a sample that, of course, I can't find. Well, you'll see what it looks like when we get done. So I'm going to bring in, this is a watercolor tag, and let's bring in, we'll use Niagara Falls, which is the fresco color, and we'll bring in amethyst. So what you can do, if you take one of the mini ink blending tools, and I like it because it's round and I like round things, and you put some color out, and you kind of pick color up on one side of the ink blending tool and you pick the other color up on the other side of the ink blending tool, you can kind of work with this in a similar fashion. So I'm going to ink up one side and then I'm going to come and ink up the other. Now there's definitely going to be some blending going on in the middle, but one of the fun things that you can do with this, this is a smooth and sturdy 3x4, so I can stamp this and I have that, or I can twist it and I get this really cool kind of blend of color. Now, either one of these is interesting in and of itself, but once the fresco paint dries and it's matte, well, now I'm going to get, again, we keep coming back to that contrast between very flat paint and very metallic paint. So I'm just going to put a little bit more out here. I forget the name of this stencil. I use it a lot and never can remember the name of it, so I'm at least consistently unable to remember. Pick up a little bit more of this, and then I'm just going to start tapping through the openings of the stencil. And if I think I need a little bit, whoops, well, that didn't go to plan. If I think I need a little bit more of the amethyst, I can put some more out. Now, the last time I did this, I tried not to blend quite so much, and yeah, see, that's a little bit better. Now I've got a little bit more distinct areas. So purple this way. All right, so now we can come back to this. Again, I'm not making great art here. I'm trying to show you some options for using things. And all I'm going to do is come in and start tapping this through the openings of the stencil. Now, each time I come back to reload, I have to be certain that I'm loading the right color on the right side. Otherwise, it all goes haywire. You can turn this so that you have purple on one side and continue to push that purple kind of all over the place. This is kind of the fun of experimenting. You get to see the various options for using this. Now I'm not going to do the whole thing because, again, you don't need to see me do the whole thing. But, and this is a blob, we'll ignore the blob where I didn't do a very good job applying the paint. But you can see that, again, once the fresco finish dries and it becomes flat, now I have contrast between color, I have contrast between finish, and you get that really cool effect. So whether you're working with the huge glitter pieces in the Galaxy Glitter, which is just such a fun kind of effect. Or you're working, see, sorry, didn't hold that very long, did I? Or you're working with the Extreme Sheen, which just produces that amazing metallic effect. I think you're going to like the way that these products look when you combine them with the Fresco Finish paint.